The death toll rose on both sides of the Israel-Gaza border conflict on Sunday. Among those reported dead is Hamas commander Hamed Ahmed al-Qadari, whom Israel blames for transferring funds from Iran to militants in Gaza. Qadari was killed in his car in a targeted strike, the first such attack by Israel since 2014. Israel's military says more than 600 rockets have been fired at southern Israel since Friday, and that Israel has attacked 260 targets linked to militant groups Hamas and Islamic Jihad.
The IDF is ready, prepared, and equipped to continue to fight against Hamas, ultimately to defend Israeli civilians against rockets fired from Gaza at Israel.
The border clashes are the most serious since a spate of fighting in November. Israeli officials say the latest round of violence began when an Islamic Jihad sniper fired at Israeli troops. Islamic Jihad accuses Israel of delaying the implementation of understandings aimed at ending violence and easing blockaded Gaza's economic hardship. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said Sunday he ordered the military to continue massive strikes against Gaza's militant groups.
This morning I instructed the Israeli Defense Forces to continue with massive strikes against terrorists in Gaza, and I also instructed that forces around Gaza be backed up with tank, artillery, and infantry forces. Hamas bears responsibility not only for its own attacks and actions, but also for those of the Islamic Jihad, for which it pays a very high price.
The United States says Israel has the right to defend its territory.
Also, I've seen a video that we can't validate just yet, but where there have been strikes on homes, civilian populations. These rockets were fired with civilians around them in order to protect return fire. This is terrible. The Israelis have every right to protect the sovereignty of their nation, and I hope that we can return to the ceasefire that had been in place for weeks and had been holding significantly before this.
The latest Israeli-Palestinian border clashes came as Muslims began the holy month of Ramadan and Israel prepares for the celebrations of its Independence Day. Zlatica Hoke, VOA News, Washington.